adapting an old stereo to run on all voltages around the world. I bought this Panasonic RXDT707 back in the early 90s in the UK. I relocated across the Atlantic where 110 volts is the default supply. I would up the voltage to run the stereo by using this super heavy external transformer, which was very inconvenient. I decided to open up the stereo and replace the 220 volts transformer with a small switching power supply, which can work from 100 to 240 volts on the input side. I know audiophiles may look in horror for using a switching power supply as opposed to using a power supply with some fancy donut transformer which produces less noise. But let's face it, this Panasonic isn't some classic amp like a Marantz 2270, so I will continue with my budget solution. I disconnected the stereo's power cable from the wall, opened up the case and took out the main power board. Before I go on, I must warn you that some parts of the main board will be live with high voltage, but I will be staying clear of those areas. I reconnected the main power cord and the inline external transformer. I measured the AC voltage on the secondary side of the transformer using a multimeter. The reading was 14 volts AC. After this, I disconnected the main power cord from the wall socket. Next, I powered the board using a bench power supply set to 15 volts DC rather than 14 volts AC. We will lose at least 1 volt across the rectifier diodes. I connect the positive clip to the positive side of the first diode after the secondary side of the transformer, and the negative clip to the negative rail of the rectifier bridge. There are 3 different DC voltage outputs from this power board. I decided it'd be far easier to just connect the new 15 volts power supply before the rectifier bridge, even though there is nothing to rectify. The maximum current draw was around 0.55 amps when opening the CD drawer. If you don't have a bench power supply, you could measure the current draw using a clamp meter. I decided to buy a switching power supply with a rating of 100 to 240 volts on the input side and 15 volts DC on the output, 2 amps maximum current draw. The cost was very low, $4 or $5 with shipping. I could have got away with a 1 amp power supply, but I preferred not to take any chances as many manufacturers of cheap power supplies exaggerate the current rating. Now to remove the old transformer. This solder wick was a bad purchase and it is useless removing solder. To overcome this, I soaked the wick with a mixture of rosin and isopropyl alcohol. Some light leverage and the board is free. I cleaned up the board with isopropyl alcohol and some wipes. Now to solder some wires going from the incoming high voltage rails to the plug power pins on the new power supply, whilst respecting the correct polarity. The output of the new power supply is wired to the input of the rectifier bridge, and again respecting the correct polarity. I insulated any exposed metal after soldering the wires to the pins of the power plug. A quick test whilst using 110 volts on the input from the wall socket. All looks good, so I apply some hot glue over the new contacts and wires so they won't move. I place back the power board in its original location. The new switching power supply is secured in place with some hot glue. This isn't the prettiest solution, but nobody will see it. Another test after final assembly and all is good. I will be releasing another video in this series adding a Bluetooth receiver module to this old stereo, so keep an eye open for that one. If the video was useful, please consider leaving a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.